Okay, happy Tuesday. Those of you that follow my channel know that on Tuesdays, that's always the day of the week that we have the lowest number of listings that are on the market. This Tuesday's no exception. Inventory starts going up as you get close to the weekend, although that barely happened last week. Now, I thought I'd never see the day where we'd have less than 8,000 listings on the market, but every day is a new record, and it's getting worse. 5,578 homes. That's it. First 12 days of January have seen listings arriving at a feeble rate, lowest in the past 3 years. So the outlook for buyers this year is pretty dire. And buyers right now outnumber sellers about 5-1. So basic economics tell us that prices are going to come flying up the next 6 months. It's already baked in the cake. So that's going to be tough. And we're eventually going to reach a point where there's an affordability problem, but not yet. I mean, the buyers that are out there, they're, you know, we're putting about 3,700 homes under contract on a weekly basis now. That's fairly brisk. That's not up to the levels that we saw, I want to say, in November. But it's outnumbering the number of listings that are coming on now by about 400 homes. So that's pretty bad. We're less than a 2 week supply out there. So you've never seen that. Now, having said that, what do you do if you're a buyer? Well, you know, you can get lucky. Sometimes you'll just get your offer accepted, but you gotta be quick. So have your agent set you up on a subscription so that when the house that you're looking for comes on, you immediately get notified, because that's a much better way to proceed than just sitting back and waiting for something to show up on Zillow and then calling an agent. I see that all the time. Get your agent involved early with you, because sometimes they hear of a home that's coming on or they see it coming soon. Don't be one of those people that sits back, looks at Zillow and goes, this is a nice house, I got to find an agent. That's just bad math in this market. Make your offer pretty sweet. And it's not always better because it's a higher price. You know, make a reasonable offer. Don't go below list price. I'm not even going to look at you right now. But offer to pay, offset and pay their closing costs. That runs about $2,000 in general. Do other things. Maybe have earnest money that goes hard after the inspection period. Earnest money gets refunded to you if you can't get your financing. But the buyer, the seller is going to want, you know, some skin in the game if they're going to pull their house off the market. So giving them an earnest money that goes hard, let's say it's about $5,000. If you don't get their get the financing, they get to keep it. So that begs you to make sure that you're highly qualified and that your lender's got you as ready to go as he possibly can, so that you have all the confidence in the world that you can offer hard earnest money. So it's time to get creative out there if you're looking to buy. If you're looking to sell, I'm a broken record. And I'm going to be introducing a program here in a couple of weeks I think you're all going to like, so stay tuned. Do me a favor, smash the heck out of that like button.